Now, smooth pursuit tracking test, as we've said before, is more of a voluntary reactive test. And what we are doing here is we're looking at the patient's ability to keep a small, slow-moving object in the fovea, identifying the retinal slip and making a correction appropriately. Now, this can be tested at different speeds, either with fixed velocity or increasing velocity, to identify any impairment that may be present. So what we can see here is we have our target that has moved in a very sinusoidal fashion, and the eye movement is tracking and moving both at the same speed and distance as the target. We can look at different parameters within the smooth pursuit. So we can look at gain as being a measure of the eye movement versus the target movement. We can look at whether the movement is within phase of the target movement. And we can also look at any asymmetry, as with our example with intranuclear ophthalmoplegia. We could have an asymmetric palsy, therefore a direction in to the left or to the right may elicit a abnormal eye movement that would be identifiable through our smooth pursuit examination. Here is an example of a bilateral symmetric abnormality. So what we can see is we've got an almost correction being applied both to the right and to the left directions to keep the eye tracking with the trace. Lesions that are bilateral identify within the central nervous system often diffuse cortical changes, again basal ganglia changes and cerebellar disease. We do have to be mindful of medication, and I'll talk about that a little bit further into our presentation, and also age. Pursuit is very sensitive to age related changes, and therefore we need to consider this as we look at older populations. A unilateral change either in the right or left direction identifies slightly different areas within the central nervous system as being involved in that pathway. So we may be now thinking more of a focal lesion or an ipsilateral cerebellar hemisphere, such as an ischemic event, or within the brainstem or the parietal occipital lobes.